Dr. Suraya Binti Suleiman, Head of English Language Department, and Mr. S. Murthy, Coordinator of PPIS and PTESL GSET 2011 December intake. I would like to invite Praveen Kumar, acting as the producer of our play, to present Dr. Suraya with a token of appreciation.
A very good afternoon to the Honorable Dr. Suraya Suleiman, Head of English Department, Mr. S. Murthy, Program Coordinator, PPISMB, TESOL GSET, December 2011 intake, Head of Departments, lecturers, and of course, my beloved friends. I'm happy to welcome all of you to our play production this afternoon. On behalf of crew members, I would like to share a few words on my experience in organizing this play. We all work together as a team in order to complete the assignment for the English studies. We face a lot of obstacles during the preparation, and yet we managed to overcome all of those problems. All the problems we faced during the making of this play have enriched us not only in terms of English, but also the experience and knowledge gained throughout the activity. Overall, I would like to say that this play production has brought unity and positive changes among us. So, on behalf of PPISMB TESOL GSET December 2011 intake, I would like to convey our heartfelt thanks especially to our director, deputy director and head of English Language Department for giving us the green light to run this play production. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank our beloved lecturers, Dr. Premalata Paskaranayan and Ms. Nandura for the guidance and assistance that they provided us throughout the staging of this play. Last but not least, I would like to thank our beloved crew members for the cooperation and the support given throughout the making of this play. I hope we could continue our teamwork and organize more activities together in the future. Without you all, we will never have complete this task. Before I end my speech, I would like to end my speech by saying, keep trying. Thank you.
Thank you to our producer Praveen Kumar. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon and welcome. We, students of PPISMB TESOL GSET 2011 intake, staging of our play production, Florence by Alice Childress. Before we proceed with the play, let us sit back and watch some of the atrocities committed on humankind by humans themselves. In the words of Martin Luther King, we must face the tragic fact that the Negro is still not free. 100 years later, the life of the Negro is still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and chains of discrimination. 100 years later, the Negro still lives on a lonely island of poverty in the midst of a vast ocean of material prosperity. 100 years later, the Negro is still languishing in the corners of American society and finds himself an exile in his own land. So, we here today to dramatize an appalling condition. Ladies and gentlemen, let this slideshow presentation be the point of entry into our play today. So, sit back and the show begins.
Thank you. bad on me. I tried to get back to Dad. He don't like me in the house by himself.
You red bang, you know he means Florence.
He's just a little fellow. He needs his mother. You make a phone call. She ain't gonna get rich out there, Elf. He can't afford to do for her, you know.
You know, Florence don't like the South.
They want me like in this world. You tell her that.
If Mr. Jack asks you about the rent, you tell me. We're gonna be literally on a comfort tree.
I will talk to him. Don't worry so about everything, Mama.
Oh, what you carry, Mama? Bring. If Mr. Jake won't bring, you might drag him. You know the silence means or something.
Mama!
If push comes to show, we got to ask him.
Don't forget to eat your lunch. Try to get seat near the window so that you can lean on your elbow and get a little rest.
Yes.
Don't forget to eat your lunch at the same time. Some coffee when the man comes through. You need something hot and you can't go to dinner.
I know that. You told me that not the dream hot.
You got handkerchief?
I got everything, Marge.
I know. Florence is a real bad old hot. Then call on us for money. You make a phone call. She ain't gonna get you up there, and we can't afford to do for her.
You've told her that before.
Well, you heard the beast bring on her. She has a notion a Negro woman does need.
But she was in the play. Don't she send us $25 for me?
For 2 weeks!
When the play was over.
It's not money, Mama. Sarah brought us Bobby. You know what she said? Florence was doing sweeping the stage.
She was in the place.
Be a sales girl. Now we need to have something.
on a trip?
Hello, I'm fine, thank you. I'm going to Judea.
How is it was me? Are you gonna stay?
No, Mr. Brown. I'm bringing Florence. I'm visiting her.
Say hello to her. She's a fine girl.
Thank you.
My brother Venus in Georgia now.
Well, now? That's nice.
Yeah, Atlanta.
Is your brother going to school?
Yes. Oh, he saw Florence in a moving picture, a colored moving picture.
What? She didn't say a word to me.
They got a moving, colored moving theater in Atlanta.
Yes. Is your brother going to be a doctor?
No, he writes names.
Oh.
My son is going back to Howard next year.
He thinks Howard to go to school to be anything.
Yes, Mama, it sure does.
It sure was a nice church. Such a good night and other night.
Yes, Mama. Oh, we raised $87 last night.
Oh, that's really nice.
Mama. You buy a ticket from Mr. Daly?
No, much bought it yesterday.
Thank God. That man is real me. Especially if he thinks you're going north. Well, Mama, if you're going to the restroom, use the colored mats. The other one is not afforded. And the train's gonna be late this evening. It's number 42.
I don't mind waiting. Thank you, sir. If you excuse me, I'd like to go to the
restroom.
Call me ma'am.
It's so soft. Mrs. Carter, these people are still fighting the civil law. I'm really a New Yorker now. Of course, I was born here, in the South, I mean. Memphis, listen, am I annoying you? I've simply got to talk to someone.
No, Mrs. Carter, it's perfectly all right.
Yes, fine. You see, Jeff has ceased writing. Stop, just like that.
Is that so?
Yes, the reviews came on his last book. Poor fellow.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Mrs. Carter, they don't like his book?
Well, you know, Jeff's Mr. Wiley is a genius. He said they missed the point, lost the whole message.
Did you read?
Do you know? Have you ever heard of Lost My Lonely Way?
No, ma'am. I can't say I have.
For it doesn't matter. It's profound. Real, you know. It's about two people.
That's nice.
Jeff poured his complete self into it. Really dug into the heart of the problems. Poor the fucker. He hardly stopped for his meals. And of course, I wasn't here to see that he didn't overdo. And he so suffered with his characters.
I guess he wants to be fast.
Then, there's his hero. Thelma, a perfect character.
She was colored, man.
Oh, yes. But of course you don't know what it's about, do you?
No, miss. Would you tell me?
Well, she's almost five, see? Really, you can tell except in small ways. She wants to be a lawyer. And there she's full of complex and excess deep shame, you know?
Do tell. What shame has she got?
It's obvious. This lovely creature, intelligent, ambitious, and well, she's a negro.
Yes, ma'am. You say that.
Surely you understand. She constantly hating herself. Just before she dies, she saves me. Right on the bridge.
How sad. Isn't it a shame she had to die?
It was inevitable. Couldn't be any other way.
Why did she sit on the bridge?
Well, just before she jumped.
You mean she killed herself?
Of course. Close your eyes and picture it.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, she's standing on the bridge in the moonlight. Out of her shabby purse, she takes the mirror. And by the light of the moon, she looks at the reflection in the glass.
I can see her just as plain.
Tears roll down her cheeks, and she says it.
Even the bus driver passing in the seat in the front seat, because they think she's white. And she says as clear as two things. I'm sitting where my people go to see my law. I am a Negro woman.
But there you have it. The exception makes the rule. That's true.
No such thing. My cousin tells me as white as you, and he never.
Are you losing your temper? Are you angry with me?
No, ma'am. Excuse me, please. I just made that my cousin Henson wanted the shoe store in the college kitchen. He never wants something to be a sad.
Bye.
It's entirely my fault, you know. This whole thing is a completely controversial subject. It is too much for Jeff. Well, naturally, I shouldn't discuss it with you. I'm sorry. Let me apologize.
No need for that, man.
I've drifted away from. What started all of this?
Your brother, man.
Yes. Well, I had to come down and sort of hold his hand over the reviews. He just thinks too much in studies. And he knows the Negro so well that sometimes our friend sees him say he almost like, well, you know.
Yes, man.
But, you know, it's really difficult to understand you people. However, I keep trying.
Thank you, man.
Last week, why? Do you know what I did? I sent $1,000 to a Negro college, a scholarship.
That was the right kind of you.
I know what's going on your mind. And what you're thinking is wrong. I've eaten with Negroes.
Yes, man.
And there's how. If it weren't the guidance for Jeff, he would never eat his food. Malcolm is a Negro.
Yes, man.
Anything you did, I feel grateful.
I don't like to tell this,
Fanny at all. I've got to. It's clearly my duty. Jack's books, Tiny Malcolm's poetry, it isn't enough. Oh, I know it isn't. Have you ever heard of Nava Rugby?
No, ma'am. I don't know anyone much except right here.
She is in California, but she's more against the game. Hey, it's California.
Yes, ma'am.
A most versatile woman. Rides, directs, acts, and everything.
That's nice.
She's uprooting herself and moving to her first home, New York, to tell that Love Flowers is musical.
Yes, ma'am.
She's great. Have so many people, and I'm sure she will have your... What's her name?
Florence.
Yes, Florence. She will have to make a place for her.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, let's see. The best thing to do would be to give you the telephone number since you're going there.
Yes, ma'am.
Your daughter will love her if she is a disabled
girl. She's a good girl. Never a bit of trouble. Except for her husband, and neither one of them could help them.
Oh,
he was still a watching time. He was a good man.
I guess it's worse than losing him in the war.
We all got our problems passing through here.
Your dear daughter to call to this number about a week from now.
Thank you, ma'am.
Her experience won't matter with Nava. I know she will understand and I'll go too.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'll just tell her no heavy washing or ironing. Just light cleaning and little cooking. Does she cook?
Ma'am?
Oh, don't worry. That won't matter with Nava. I will take your daughter myself, but I'm good being. She's been with me for years, and I just can't let her go, can I?
No, ma'am.
Of course, she must be steady, and I couldn't ask Melba to take a flight by night. But she will have her own room and bar, above all, security.
Child!
You're holding my wrist!
I mustn't hurt you. Must I?
That's all right.
You better go to the other side. It's against the law for you to be over here with me.
If you think so.
I don't like to break the law.
I know I must look a fright. The train should be along soon. When it comes, I will see you until the New York. These silly laws. I'm going to powder my nose.
Thank you.
lady?
She's in the lake. You got a stand?
No. But I can get one out of the machine 3-4 times.
Put one on here and leave it for me.
See? You are writing Florence when you are visiting her.
Want a good lunch? Just chicken and fruit.
Sure, thanks. But you won't.
I ain't got to see Florence for a long time. Might be never.
How's that, Mrs. Whitley?
She can be anything in this world she wants to be.
That's her right.
Marge can't make her turn back.
Mrs. Carter can't make her turn back.
Lost my lonely way. That's a book. People kill themselves, first look wide but be black. They just don't understand.
Oh, Mrs. Whitney, whatever happens, don't you fret now. Life is too short.
Oh, I've got a friend, that's
so what I have fallen.
No, Mama, you don't have to tell me.
Say, me, child.
Thank you. like a black hole. Spend my life being a color.
Damn, you agree with me when I saw you kicking dirt in my eye.
You're black or white.